So first, delete the cube and add up. Scale that up according to your scene. Now go to the edit mode and press F3 and then type subdivide. Click on it and change the number of cuts to 80. Now go to the sculpting tab and sculpt your landscape according to your scene. Now once you are done, then go back to the layout tab and then go to the modifiers tab and add a remesh modifier. Now change the mode to blocks. Change the octadrift to 6 or according to your need. Now you can also edit the landscape in the sculpting mode. Now once you are satisfied with your landscape, apply the remesh modifier. Now you can add more landscape like this using the same method. Adjust your camera according to your need. Now go over the shading tab. Now add a new material. And press Ctrl G. Make sure that you have turned on the node wrangler and on. Go to the edit mode and press U and then click reset. Open the image of the grass top. We see that the image is very blurry. To fix this, change this to closest. Now open the image of grass side. Then add a mix RGB node. And change the mode to multiply. Set the factor to 1 and pick up the color from the image of the grass side. Turn the specularity to 0. Now go to the edit mode and select the faces and go over the select tab and select normal. Similarly, select all the faces except the top and the bottom. Then add a new material and then select the grass material and duplicate it. Open the grass side image. And delete the mix RGB node. Assign the material to the selected faces. See that the faces are not correctly rotated. So go to the UV editor and rotate or scale it until it fits perfectly. Similarly, select the other faces and fix it. Follow the same procedure and add the materials to the other landscape. To make some variation in grass, select the faces which you want to make stone or dirt. Add the grass material and change the image to dirt or stone and assign them. Similarly, you can add some stone or dirt in other landscapes. Now, once you are satisfied with the look, go to the Layout tab and delete the default light. Change this to World. And then add an environment texture node. And plug the color into color. And open your choice HDRI texture. Now you can adjust your objects according to the HDRI. To make the trees, go to the Layout tab and add a cube. Align it to your landscape. And make sure that the size of the cube is same as the one block of your landscape. Once you are done with that, go to the Modifiers tab and add a Array modifier. Now, with the help of this modifier, adjust the length of the tree. And apply that. Go over the shading tab . Change this to object and add a new material. Go to the edit mode and select all the faces and hit U and reset them. Then change the image texture to o'clock. Then again align and rotate the faces to fit the size of the tree. Duplicate the tree. Now extrude the upper face of the tree. Then add an array modifier. Change the number of counts to 4. Apply the array modifier. Select the faces and extrude them to make it look like a tree. Then add the word material and duplicate that. Change the picture to oak leaves. And make sure that you reset the objects in the edit mode. Plug the alpha into alpha of the principal shader. You can see that the blocks have now turned transparent. Then add a mixed RGB shader and change the color as that of the grass. To make the grass, you can add a plane and scale it like this. Similarly, you can add the oak leaves material and change the picture to bottom grass. Duplicate them and place all over the landscape. Also, duplicate the trees and place them all over the landscape. You can also make a small flower using the same steps as we made the grass. And change the image to any Minecraft flower. Similarly, add grass and trees to all the landscape. You can also animate the camera using the keyframes and the graph editor. Once you are satisfied with the look, finally render it and make sure that the render engine is cycles and the file format is FFmpeg video.